Hello guys, welcome back. It's your barely free-to-play players, Takurun. So what we have here today is the May 2019 balancing packs. So for the first one they have is a nerf to Artamil. Now as you guys know it, Artamil has been a cancerous unit in RTA. He has the number one most win statistic, and whenever I see him in RTA, I have no choice but to ban him because he's just going to do cancerous shit and it's going to guarantee you a lose. So what they did here is decrease the attack bar that Artamil is going to get and the defense per hit per counter that he's going to gain. But eventually, as the fight goes on, he is still going to get 100% defense buff. So this is, in my opinion, just a very small nerf, doesn't change the mechanics, and Artamil is still going to strip, going to stun you, and that's still going to make him cancerous. Next, we have the Harp Magician, or as you guys like to call her, Fissure Shell. Now, Fissure Shell can no longer put one of your unit HP into one and immediately one-shot him with the first skill. Instead, she's going to put herself to sleep, and she must rely on whoever moves next in the team to finish off that unit. So I guess that's fair. Next, we have the biggest buff, the biggest change that's going to stir the meta. It's Fran, guys. Finally, this nerf has been long overdue. Now, Fran no longer stuns, but instead decreases the attack bar of the opponent. So, in my opinion, Fran is still going to be a meta pick, because there's no other unit that can do what she does. She can buff 2-turn immunity, plus 2-turn attack buff, and that's insane, especially for one-shot comp and double immunity comp. I actually see a pro to Fran's nerf, because usually when I pick Fran, the opponent is going to immediately pick Josephine to counter her. And since Fran no longer stuns, Josephine can no longer, you know, provoke the Fran to abuse the first skill to get her passive activated. So there's actually a silver lining to this nerf. Next we have the Valkyrija. Now the Valkyrija is going to make sure that her allies will not get crit so much. This, in my opinion, can counter units such as Ferd and Diana. Because you know, if you're a Diana user, you transform into a human, then you use your second skill, but only to find yourself getting 50% attack bar. And that's not good. Next, the Valkyrie is going to just silence you, and that's going to guarantee you a death. Bye, Pony! Next, we have the Hell Lady Light. So this basically means that she's going to be a better nuker, she's going to deal more damage. And speaking of damage, we have the Sea Emperor Water Poseidon. Now what they're trying to do here is make Water Poseidon become the next Lagmaron. The only difference is that Lagmaron is wind while he is water. So they are both nukers now. You can use them both in a cliff comp and it's going to give you a very good result. Next we have Daphnis. Daphnis, the monster that everybody complains is the weakest among the Fairy King. So guess what guys, they buff him again. Now, after stripping the debuff from the enemy, he's going to first land a defense break on the enemy before nuking that enemy. This, guys, if you rune your Daphnis on attack crit damage attack, imagine the damage that he's going to do with the third skill. In fact, he's going to one-shot mostly, you know, unit like Ferd and even your Fran. So, from this I can already see many more one-shot comp, like Molong, Daphnis, Perna, with Bastet. It's going to be... I mean, our life in RTA is going to be more hellish because of this. Next, we have the Desert Windfire. In my opinion, this is actually the most adorable buff. Now that every time Sekhmet is going to miss her third skill, I mean the reset, she's going to have another chance to use it next turn. It's like they are admitting that Sekhmet is going to fail on landing the reset every time. I don't know about this buff, because usually when you miss your Charming Voice, it's already too late. Next, the enemy is going to move like Okeanos and they're going to reset you back. And most of the time, Sekhmet is built on Swift anyway, so there's no violent proc chance to use the third skill again. Next, we have the Monkey King, Wind Element. Now, he is more tanky and has a higher chance to counter-attack when you attack the ally. I can see this as a nerf to, you know, units like Jaeger, Siho, and other water units that has multiple AoE attacks. Now they are forced to attack the Wind Monkey if they don't wanna get fucked up by his, you know, counter. Next we have the Cobalt Bomber. Now I don't know if this is a hit or hits unit, but if it is, then it's going to be the next Gemini. I mean, as OP as the next Gemini, because now not only does he strips, he's going to land silence 2 turns on all the enemies. It's like having both Triton 3rd skill and 2nd skill all together in one. It's crazy, guys, it's crazy. And now we have the Water Pirate. Increase the damage by 50% for its beneficial effects on the enemies. So basically, if you guys bring her to your cliff comp, and if the enemy has Will Runes, which most of the time they do, it's going to compensate for that Alicia leader skill that she doesn't have. Which in my opinion is actually good. Now she can be on par with Alicia for those of you guys who do not have Alicia. Now this Cowgirl's buff are so irrelevant that I'm going to just skim through them. Now we have here the awakening effect of some monsters. Oh, but this guys, this is actually a buff. Now, like Panda Warrior doesn't have to suffer just because they nerf Molong. They revert back Molong's second skill, not Molong. They revert back Tianlang's second skill to where it was. And now not only does it strips, not only does it stun, it also decreases the attack bar of the enemies that he attacks. Insane. As a third user in RTA, I don't like where this is going. Next we have the Sea Emperor with. Oh wow guys. Now instead of getting accuracy from awakening, he's going to get 15 speed. What this means is that Triton is going to be the fastest strippers in the game. And not only a faster stripper, but his third skill actually pushes back the attack bar of the enemies. This means that you can use Triton as the reverse effect of Tiana. From this, I can already see so many Triton being used in arena defenses, and also perhaps in double stripper RTA comp. What do you guys think? You guys think that we'll be seeing more Triton on arena defense? Please let me know in the comment section. Next, we have the Paladins. So basically, they take away their leader skill from Guild Wars. So you guys won't be seeing any more 50-55% leader skill from Giant Defenses. Oh, so what this means is that I believe there's going to be less Giant Defenses out there, which most of the people already complain about. They say that those Giant Defenses are so annoying, they stall so much time. And with this, I think we're going to see less Paladin Defenses now. Instead, we can use Paladin defense leader skill on RTA. And as a Paladin user in RTA, I am actually happy with this. So yeah, that's all the pets. What do you guys think of this pet? Is it meh? Is it one of the best pets you've ever seen? Please let me know. Alright guys, see you later. Peace out.